إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Indeed, the praise is for Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help, and we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils that are within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can lead this person astray. And whomsoever Allah leads astray, there is no guide for him. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah, who is alone with our partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the servant of Allah and the last messenger to all of mankind. O you who believe, fear Allah with the right that He should be feared with, and do not die unless you are Muslims, practicing the deen of Al-Islam. O mankind, fear your Lord, who has created you from a single person, and from that person created his mate, and from them too scattered countless men and women throughout the earth. And fear Allah from who you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut off the relations with the wombs that have bore you. Indeed, Allah is a watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah, and say that which is correct and upright, in order that Allah may rectify for you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved a tremendous achievement. As to what follows, certainly the most truthful speech is the Book of Allah, the Quran. And the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his sunnah. And the most evil of the affairs are the newly invented matters in the religion. And every newly invented matter in the religion is innovation, and every innovation is going astray, and every going astray is in the hellfire. We have the narration on the authority of Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu. قال أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله عز وجل أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه حيث يذكرني. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah عز وجل stated, I'm with my servant in the manner that he thinks of me. I am with my servant in the manner that he thinks of me. And I am with him whenever he remembers me. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went on to state, Wallahi lallah afrah bi tawbati abdihi min ahadikum yajidu dallatahu bil falah. The Prophet, he said, I swear by Allah, indeed Allah is more happy with the repentance of his servant than the happiness of one of you who finds his lost animal in a barren land. Then he went on to mention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he stated, Man taqarraba ilayya shibran taqarrabtu ilayhi dira'an. وَمَنْ تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا. Allah, he stated, and whoever draws near to me a hand span, I draw near to him an arm span. And whoever draws near to me an arm span, I draw near to him the distance of a fathom. وَإِذَا أَقْبَلَ إِلَيَّ يَمْشِي أَقْبَلْتُ إِلَيْهِ حَرْوَلًا. Then Allah, he mentions, if the servant comes to me walking, if he turns to me walking, I turn to him running towards him. This statement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam shows the importance of having a good thought about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as Muslims are commanded in Islam to have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never should we have bad thoughts, evil thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we think about Allah in a good way, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us good. But if we think about Allah in an evil way, then for us is evil. There is another narration where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he stated, Ana inda dhanni abdi bi إن ظن خيرا فله وإن ظن شرا فله. I'm with my servant in the manner that he thinks of me. If he thinks good of me, then for him is good. And if he thinks evil of me, then for him is evil. So we must be mindful to always have good thoughts about Allah. No matter how hard life may become, no matter what we are faced with from the trials and tribulations, we must maintain having a good thought about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was heard by Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu anhuma 3 days before the death of the Prophet. And this is very important that Jabir, he said this radiallahu an, that he heard the Prophet say 3 days before his death, meaning that this is something that Islam is established upon. This is something that is extremely important, being that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned this 3 days before his death. He said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, la yamutanna ahadukum illa wa huwa yuhsin adh-dhann billah. Let not one of you die except that he has a good thought and opinion about Allah. Meaning, don't let death come to you except that you have good thoughts about Allah. And if death comes to you while you have bad thoughts about Allah, and you die upon having bad thoughts about Allah, That's an evil situation to die upon. Because the one who dies with bad thoughts about Allah, he's resurrected just as he has died. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, إِنَّمَا الْعَبْدُ يُبْعَثُ عَلَى مَا مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ. Indeed, the servant is resurrected upon what he died on. If a person dies upon good thoughts about Allah, he's resurrected upon good thoughts with Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to visit a youth. And this youth was upon his deathbed. And that is the reminder that death does not discriminate. The old as well as the young die. There is no such thing that only the old people die. And the youth get to live until they reach the old age. Children die, babies die. Teenagers die, young adults die, elderly, they die. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul tastes death. Death is not restricted to the elders. So the Prophet, he went to visit a youth who was dying on his deathbed. He said, كَيْفَ تَجِدُكَ. How you find yourself to be? How are you? What's your state? In the youth, he said, أَرُجُ اللَّهِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَإِنِّي أَخَافْ ذُنُوبِي. He said, O Messenger of Allah, I have hope for the mercy of Allah, but at the same time, I'm afraid of my sins. SubhanAllah wa bihamdihi. He combined between hope and fear. He didn't just have hope, saying that Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. My sins are not going to be anything with Allah because Allah is going to forgive everything. He says this and he feels this way with surety. No, he had hope for the mercy of Allah, but at the same time, he was afraid of Allah's punishment. So what did the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? He said, لا يجتمعان في قلب عبد في مثل هذا الموطن إلا أعطاه الله ما يرجو وأمنه الله مما يخاف. Never do these two affairs, meaning hope and fear. Never does hope and fear come together in the heart of a servant at the time of death, except that Allah will give him what he hopes for, and Allah will protect him from what he fears. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين وصلى الله وسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد. The next point to be mentioned from the narration is that Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He is happy, or rather Allah is with the servant whenever the servant thinks of him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu thkurullah dhikran kathira. O you who believe, remember Allah in abundance. Remember him with abundant remembrance. Meaning constantly remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we remember Allah, the more Allah is with us. He is with us by protecting us, aiding us, giving us victory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the servant when the servant remembers him. And the more the servant remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more successful he will be in life. وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And remember Allah abundantly in order that you may be successful. And what is meant by remembering Allah abundantly? Remembering Allah with the legislated adhkar. Not the innovative adhkar. Not the made up adhkar. The legislated adhkar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to say in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, when waking up from sleep, when going to bed, when putting on our clothing, when entering the home, leaving the home. The legislated adhkar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us in the different aspects and situations in life, we say them. This is remembering Allah abundantly. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after the five daily prayers, according to how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to remember Allah. Not remembering Allah the way we want to remember Allah. The Prophet is the teacher sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the role model and the example. Perfection is in that which the Prophet came with, and that is Islam. So we remember Allah the way Allah has legislated for us to remember Him, and we do this abundantly, and Allah will be with us. Allah will give us success. Allah, He mentioned, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Therefore, remember me and I will remember you. What a beautiful reward for remembering Allah. Lastly, the importance of turning to Allah with tawbah, seeking the repentance, or making repentance and seeking the forgiveness of Allah. At-tawbah wal-istighfar, repenting and seeking forgiveness, this is what draws Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala near to us. Allah Azza wa Jal will aid us and protect us. But we have to turn to Him. We have to make the initiative to change our affair from evil to good, from sin to obedience. We go to Allah a handspan, Allah comes to us an armspan. We turn to Allah an arm span, Allah turns to us the distance of a fathom. We walk towards Allah, Allah runs towards us. This is the reward for the servant making the initiative to change his affair from bad to good. All we have to do is take the step, make the effort. Don't let shaitan tell you that it's over for you. As long as you are breathing, as long as we are breathing, as long as we wake up in the morning, we have a chance and the opportunity to change our life around. The man from Bani Israel killed 99 people. Allah forgave him because he made the effort to repent. He made an effort. A man during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to the masjid and said, O Messenger of Allah, I did everything with the woman except have relations with her. What can I do? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, did you pray with us? The man said, yes. The Prophet mentioned the statement of Allah, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Indeed, the good deeds wipe out the bad deeds. We have to make the effort to do good. And when we are striving to do good, that's going to wipe out the evil that we have done and the mistakes that we have made in life. And we all make mistakes. So don't despair from the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Say, oh my servants who have wronged themselves. That's all of us. Every last one of us in this masjid, we have wronged ourselves in some shape, form, or fashion. How? Whenever we commit a sin, whenever we fall short, we are wronging ourselves. But what does Allah say? Don't despair from the mercy of Allah. Indeed, Allah forgives all sins. I end with the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. Al-kaba'ir al-ishraq billah wal-amn min makrillah wal-qunut min rahmatillah wal-ya's min ruhillah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, the major sins are the associating of partners with Allah. This is the greatest sin that a person can commit. Committing shirk. Secondly, feeling safe from the plan of Allah. You think Allah won't punish you. No matter how much evil you're doing, you feel comfortable being a sinner and a disobedient servant. You feel safe from the plot and the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against the wrongdoers. This is from the major sins. Don't feel safe in a state of sinning and disobeying Allah. We are not safe disobeying Allah. Allah warns us against Himself. Number three, despairing from the mercy of Allah. And number four, giving up hope for the forgiveness of Allah. And these last two statements are similar, except that the scholars, they say that al-qunut is before an action. Meaning that the person, before he does an act of goodness, he's in a state of despair. He thinks that it doesn't make a difference if he does good or not. Allah is not going to be merciful to him and accept his good. And as for al-ya's, they said this is after the person has committed a sin, that he thinks that Allah will not forgive him. So when these two statements are mentioned together, the meaning is different. But whenever they are mentioned separately, the meaning is the same. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who remember him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who have a good thought of him and die upon having good thoughts of him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who turn to him and we repent to him and seek his forgiveness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take our souls while we are established upon Islam. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفُرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَسُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ. أقم الصلاة.